to do two things. I wanted to talk about misconception about money from a Christian perspective, and I'm also going to talk about the third law of money, which is investment. So I will try as much as possible to see how far I can go, because at some point I will have to leave you guys, and the rest of the team will close, because I wanted us to do an interactive session. We've done the first law, the second law. I will do the misconception and the third law, because you need to understand this series of teachings. I waited till the end of the year to bring this, because I don't want to hear capital ever in your mouth again. People say you don't have capital. I think we solved that problem here, right? You guys answer me now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
We solved that issue of how to raise capital.
Yes, yes.
We solved the first law, is the law of multiplication. And we have the formula. If you guys are not in the first and second, you can go to our YouTube, Marketplace Apostle YouTube, and you can see the first law, multiplication. How do you multiply money? That is the starting point. Then the second law was retention, law of retention. That is saving, that's financial discipline. So this third law is now when we invest. But as the Lord deals with us here, it's not direct. I will teach you investment sometimes next year. But I have seen that from my own experience, investment differ based on what you want in life, based on your area of interest. And also, to just teach a blanket investment is not something I find very interesting. But I will teach you some tips about investment, and we will now get the flow. Because if you understand the flow of how things work, it will be good for you. I told you guys when I was doing my MBA, and I encountered accounting in MBA, I had to go back to Etekudo to go and understand the concept of debit and credit. If you don't understand debit and credit, you cannot understand what they are talking about in the ledger. You have no clue, you have no idea whatsoever what they are talking about in the ledger. So the same way, understand, you see, making money is an art, is an understanding. It's about riding bicycle. And once you catch on to it, the rest becomes easy. What I'm teaching you here now is to understand the basics of how these things work. You cannot be rich if you cannot save. So the first law talked to us about savings and how to multiply money, and also how to raise capital for yourself. Also how to raise equity for yourself. So if you earn 100,000 naira a month, it means that you already have the capacity, the capability to be able to save 680,000 naira by January 2020. Whatever you earn, you should be able to start that process of having a multiplication chamber. Something is multiplying the money. Because you will regret it when the opportunity comes. When you pray to God, what God gives you is an opportunity. And He expects you to go to the multiplication chamber to collect what is there for the business. To collect what is there for the opportunity. If you don't understand, it's not when the contract comes, that's when you're going to meet your friend or boyfriend with money and get contract. You are not a serious entrepreneur, and you are not serious about wealth. If you are an employee I want you to go back to that first law and see how much you can save. Not you can, how much you are expected to save. 50% of your money is going into savings. 20%, 10% tithe. 20% goes to savings for yourself. Warehouse rent comes, where those basic things that you need, medical, that you are putting aside. So that you don't tell me that a month to the time for your rent, you are looking for money. If the money is not enough, at least you've gone halfway or more than. Then the other 20% is a business seed. That is your capital that is never to be eaten. Because when you cannot discipline yourself for that, the second law, two key things I will refresh your mind with is that as I talked about credit and debit, you have to also understand asset and liability. And we'll deal with some of the asset and liability tonight. Asset is basically interpreted. Get a picture of it. Asset is something that will add to your income and continue to appreciate. Land. Stock. Things in that direction. Liability is something you pay for and continue to pay for to maintain. So it is not just a buying, an example, a car. It's a liability. If that car is not contributing, it's not partially an asset or an asset to you, then it means that having that car is just luxury. Not for someone that is building wealth. It is a mindset. How do you retain and delay gratification? I've said this before. If you're not here, you can see all this. I just want to put this point so you understand where I'm going. How do you delay gratification? How do you hold back that money? And I said to us last week, how many billions does Coca-Cola use for advert every year? All these companies are using billions for advert every year. You know why? Because they are leveraging, they are catching on your inability to delay gratification. So they keep showing you that Coca-Cola, showing you that bottle. The next minute you go to store and you buy it because they know that the cravings of a human being, if you don't discipline yourself, you will fall into that power, that money has power. If you do not know what to do with money, when money keeps you, money begins to control you. Money is a good servant but a terrible master. And the only way you can serve, be able to allow money serve you is know where money is going into. And once you know those things mentally, when money comes, you send it to the multiplication chamber to be multiplying. Just like those days, they used to have fattening room, every fattening room. When the money comes, send them to the fattening room. Let them be making them fat and ready for their husband, which is now the transaction. If you don't understand that concept, you will not have, you see, when there is no target, when there is no purpose, when there is no purpose, what does Miles Monroe say? Abuse is inevitable. And what is the abuse now? You'll be eating the money because you have no future. Vision. Money flows in the direction of vision, in the direction of target. Then you know what you want to do with money. That is exactly what the law. Can you imagine 5% of the population of this world? 95% of the money in this world. which is like about 390 something trillion. 5% control 95% of that. Is it fair? But you see, it's fair now. Who said, nobody ever said we're in a fair world now. The world is not fair. But see the picture that makes me not be able to sleep every day. Every time you go to buy Indomie, all those things you buy with 80% of your money or 85%, 85% of the money of the poor, they carry it every month and go and bow down to the rich. Please take. In the form of Indomie, in the form of a filling station, in the form of this, you beg them. Because they control those things. So do you know what makes the rich rich? Not because it's the poor people that make the rich people rich.
Yes.
It's the poor people. Every day they're waiting. You carry your own meager money, small money. You carry to go and give to them. Because they understand. You see, money is a lifestyle. I say, all of us are supposedly born again. You cannot be born again. You must be born again before you make heaven, right?
Yes.
You must be financially born again before you become rich.
Yes.
And what do I mean? If you are not ready to change your lifestyle, you can never be rich. It's not a curse, but it's a prophecy. Making money is tightening that belt and allow the money. Let the money be breathing in the multiplication chamber. Then God will send you opportunity. I said two instances that I know that God sent money. You see, that money God sends to you is seed. And you eat your seed, so there is no harvest. They told us in church, if you are gathering the money, if it's not complete, sow it. That is fallacy. When God gives you money, He expects you to, He has given you a seed, multiply it. It's from your profit. It's from the flowing of from the capital that you've invested. The outflowing, the profit from it is what you now use.
Yes, yes.
Don't eat your capital. You know why? Next year again, you still be good as in church. And you are still poor. You cannot help the church if you are poor. If you enter a plane, they will tell you, mother, strap yourself first before you strap your child. And this brings me to the misconception. I saw something, an article, and I wrote it down somewhere. The misconception of Christians, believers, they ask them three questions. Or one question. Would you like God to entrust you with millions? How many people want God to entrust them with millions? Okay. If your answer is yes, what will you do when God gives you 1 million? What will you do with the money? And look at, for the sake of time, I will take one or two questions before. I mean, today is loaded. Today is also the opening ceremony at the Port Harcourt International Trade Fair. We have guests from all over, outside the country, outside the states, and I'm actively involved. And you can see this is our Ashwebi that we're wearing. So I need to deal with this. And also today is our last day for the year. I'm sorry that he has to fall into that, but I'll try and do the best that I can. Because next year we're dealing with other things, but I will remain also in January, February, I'll remain in the money of this talk about money. Because I need to break this. We need to break it. 2019, God said, is a very, was very tough. I know about it. God said, 2019, I know it will be tough. But 2020 will be tough for the ignorant alone. So get ready. Get ready. Change your lifestyle. That thing will not kill you. Change your lifestyle. You can do it. I was addicted to Coke and ice. You don't understand. Once you see that advert, Coke with ice, and somebody drink it, and that thing will just pass through here, that's all. But this is 4 years. Can you imagine 4 years? All I drink is water. I don't take any drink. 4 years. And I didn't stop because of health problems. So you can change. This is your reality. After a while, that thing you are doing becomes your reality. If I get home now, I'm not an accountant, but I sit down. As I'm waiting for my food, I calculate all the money that I have spent, even to 1 naira that I give anybody. What I receive, what I will, and I post it appropriately. Because I'm going somewhere. What is the target, our target here? Someone tell me, where is the target that we're entering? If you don't tell me, I'll drop this mic. What did I say all of us are going to end up? No, specifically. In that account, where did I say? I say we must have accounts that will happen.
Asset and liability.
No. Our destination is to get to a point that we have investment that will be giving us how much every month as spending money.
20 minutes.
Exactly. I want to provoke you so that this night you will not eat.
Yes.
A human being like you has an ATM that they credit 20 million. This was 2 years ago. So I don't even know if you remember. All his investment, his salary, his dividend, his whatever, every month in the companies, and what he does, he has one business that he used to do his runs. He has other companies that pay him salary and dividend. All of them put together, they credit him 20 million, and that is spending money. So he can come to your church and give 5 million, say, I'm waiting, they feel like. But it's somebody that has paid his dues. And these are the places that are coming out of Africa. Some of you will be looking at me as if it's impossible.
It's possible. It's possible.
Is this same thing that I'm telling you that the guy is doing?
Yes,
sir. No more, no less. We were supposed to travel. At the beginning of Marketplace Apostle, we were supposed to travel to meet this man that taught him this law, or that taught us this law. He wanted to meet him face to face. You know, sometimes God doesn't like crowd. But me, I wanted to take 5 people with me. It didn't work out for us to go, but it worked out for him. So he, and the man kept him in his house for 3 months. And he came back. This is the product. And this is what I shared to you. You know, in Christendom, we hide things. How did you get the anointing? You won't tell your members. You know why? Because you want them to keep coming. Making money is easy. It's a mindset thing. It's a discipline. Change your financial, change your lifestyle. So that all of us, for the sake of my children. Because if those the children of the poor are not settled, then they will worry the children of those that have. So it's a collective thing that we live in a world. Let me tell you, the Western world, and I don't care if they're watching, they don't have your interest at heart. We must, in Africa, begin to generate wealth, begin to build industries, begin to build small businesses. Don't be shy of building business. Don't be shy of making 1,000 naira. We will get to that. You will build, let me tell you, making money is like riding bicycle. It comes on you. You cannot just from, you cannot. If you have a 5-year-old and that 5-year-old is telling you that I am going to defend my PhD, you will run away from that house. There are some things that you need to know and those things you need to do. But the youth of nowadays are not. That you see, able-bodied men in my Niger Delta do nothing every day but to move from company to company. Every-bodied men, on Monday, 9 o'clock, they are drinking beer. I'm coming to work, they are drinking. Why? Because they are waiting. Christmas is coming. Some companies are going to give them money. They are looking where to. It's a shame. It's a shame on Niger Delta. And I will say it because I'm from here. It pains me. I didn't grow up here. At 40 years, I've only gone to my village 3 times. But I know the West, Southwest, how they think and how they believe. And let me tell you, the mentality there is that you do nothing. The mentality there is that you don't even go to school. The mentality there is that those that go to school don't look for work. I am telling you, that's why some things are passing us by, because men are not. I said, look, that I have always been advocate of raise 6 people, give them all the allocations, give them all the contracts, let these people in turn develop their geopolitical zone for where they ask me who are the people. That who are the people that are willing to bring, and that we will be able to sit down and allow one person to go. But that one is the truth. Are we able to bring out 6 people from Niger Delta and say, government, do this. This is what happened in South Africa to an extent. This is what happened in Russia. That's why you're having billionaires breaking forth. Go for us. You are able to go for us. You know these things. Go there and go and partner with a telecoms company that will be manufacturing there. You go and go to Israel and come and bring, go and partner with Israel, come to the north and turn it into how Israel turned a desert. This is how we should be thinking. Where is the oil now? Are we not the same people that are teaching non-oil? We are now talking about beyond oil. All the seminars are beyond oil. Beyond oil. Because now they are bringing cars that will use solar. It will clear us in our eye one day. The oil is not, it's already started. So what are we doing? My brothers, please. 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 Please, there is much more to Niger Delta. Please. Do you know how many things that can be brought out from the creeks that can be exported? Do you know how many things? Do you know how many ideas? Let's do, but the thing is that who will go for us? I do this making Nigeria starting from ICBN. It's my brothers that are pulling me down. Save my brothers from here, the ones that are pulling me down. Somebody say, and I didn't go now, tomorrow we'll talk to her, I know we're going to swell. That's why we're here. We want to get up, somebody will pull down. They are bright ideas. The last administration, I was talking to a guy, an essay there, he said, come. He opened one room for me. It's more bigger than this. Come and see proposal. He said, Nigerians have the best minds. You see, this proposal, he said, can transform the whole world, not even Africa, if we implement it. So it's not in the ideas. But we must break this thing. Making Nigeria came from making India. Its government bought over it. We are struggling to rally around human beings to promote it. But do you know that even the Making Nigeria, I've done here 9 years, the Making Nigeria is gaining more weight outside the South, the Niger Delta. Why? Let me move on. Okay, so I come back. Because only the church can break this. Only the church can break tribalism. Only the church. Only the church. It is only in the church that you can play certain music and it's accepted. It's only gospel worship. I went to my village and we were singing gospel, we were singing Yoruba song. I was looking at them. Do you understand what they were saying? None of them understood what they were saying. The same way I went to speak somewhere in after break. I went there the same thing. They were calling me Ushe, Ushe, then Mr. Ushe. They were singing Igbo songs. How can that happen? Tell me if it's not Christ that can unite. You go to your church, they sing all manner of things. I remember when my son, my children were small. If they want to sing, to go and sing this Ogoni song, they sing. That's the one they like. How can that be? It's only the gospel that can bring that. And let me tell you, it's only the entrepreneurs that can sponsor that gospel. Only you and I can sponsor that gospel. But we have been sold some, there's some misconceptions that need to be broken. Because wealth is here. Wealth is here. I believe in tithes. I believe in Church of Jesus Christ. But I do not believe in everything that we have been told. Let me bring out one. This is a researched work. They asked Christians, I give you $1 million now. 340 million now. 360 million. Call it 400 million. What will you do? The first one said, I will fast, pray, ask the Lord what I will do with the money. The second one said, I will buy a piece of property and build a rehab center. Buy building for other ministries and help them financially. This is a Christian mind. This is how we're trained. I will invest, the third person said, I will invest money in arts and media for the word of God to be preached on the television and in the theaters. Excellent. Number four says, I will build houses for homeless people. I will also give money to students who cannot pay for their education. They summarized 99.something% were in these first four. 0.something last. Fast and pray, it means that you have no concept. It means that you are like our politicians. What will remove this party? Then when we remove the party here, so what do we do? So now you are in government house. None of you have a clue.
Yes, 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 yes.
So you see them, they are always in campaign mode. Somebody sat there on a Monday budget, on a Monday meeting, you know, budget session like this, people are sad, so it's not a joke. Say, show me the money. They don't give a damn. And once you collect that, this and they give you car, give you wardrobe allowance, just be feeling, right? It's okay. You cannot sleep. My wife is a regional manager. Me too, I don't sleep. Sometimes I say, is it me that is working? Or is she two of us? She can't sleep. So we wake up, we begin to strategize on another person's money. But let me tell you, they give you a target of 500 million. How come those bankers are still? There's still people that are working in the bank, right? Because there's always a way. If there's no pressure, there's no way. If you don't place yourself under any pressure, you can't achieve anything. So if you don't discipline yourself in going through that financial pressure, then you won't be able to do anything. So that answers the first question. And money does not go to people that are not expecting it. So you can pray and pray and do, but there's nothing you are doing to expect money, it will never come. This the guy that said, I'll buy a piece of property, build houses for me. Yes, sounds noteworthy and spiritual. But spending money this way will do what? It will make you penniless within a short space of time. And God will watch you become penniless. Before spending on charity, multiply it first. You cannot help me when you just helped me once. I think it's an anomaly. I think it should be a sight that is never seen. I get out before should not be seen or heard with Christians. You know why? We have 50 million. We come to church, we give testimony, we are giving out. We are giving out. Everybody knows that this brother, God has blessed him. You know, it's just for 6 months, 1 year. Then that brother, the pastor will call that brother. This brother was so good. Let us pray. In fact, we will go to his village to address the principalities. It's a foundational issue. And I take it as an insult. I will go to that village and I will go to destroy all those shrines. They will do. They will call that village. And guess what? You will pay for that transport, for that family deliverance. You will pay. The location and the pastor will come to your house and pray and sweat blood.
Yes.
And you know the man of God cannot leave your house empty handed. You are still broke. There's no stepmother that did you. There's no witch. It's indiscipline.
Yes.
Let's call it what it is. Africa is the only place where something happens to someone. You say, what is this that happened to me? How do I make sure this thing does not come? No, in Africa, who do me this thing? In Africa, it's always another person's fault, not your fault. In Africa, it's the other person. You can never make mistakes, so we never learn and we never move forward. That is the problem in Africa. So, telling me you will build all those things, you will still come back to the broke avenue. The only reason we will know that you have made it is that your complexion is lighter. But it should not be seen. It should not be seen. Look, let me tell you. That thing that you are building, rehab center, you put your name. You are taking the glory. It's just like Jesus told the Pharisees, he said, look, when you people fast, when you fast in your inside your house, that they will fast, their mouth will be this thing. And when they pass, they say, oh, great man of God. He said, that is your reward. You see, those accolades from men is your reward. He has no reward from God. So when you act in this way, you will remain penniless. When God sends you that money, don't you understand that some people are still broke because you have not come into your element? Some people are still broke because you have not become rich. And you are not rich because you have not disciplined yourself. So before you have those highfalutin ideas about how to help the church, you help the church from your surplus. Make the money. We don't want to hear him get them before. Number three, let's address, he said, art, media. Yes, this is excellent. But we do not want to pay RSTV for 6 months for him to run a gospel ad, and after 6 months, we don't hear you for 6 years. It doesn't make sense. This will only devour your finances instead of generating a source, which will constantly generate more and more funds for future use. Number four said, I will build houses for homeless people. I will also give money to students who can pay. Oh, people will say, great man of God. But wrong understanding of money makes people assume that the first duty they owe to money is to do what? To spend. What is the first duty you have with money?
Multiply.
The first thought of money is to multiply, not to spend. 100,000 naira, 50,000 you can eat 10, 50% of 100,000 naira you can eat it anyhow you like. You don't mind. But once you have that culture, even that one you will spend with wisdom. And whatever is left, you will throw it into the multiplication table. Your first duty is to spend. The first law of money says, don't spend, invest in it. Then the 0.00% of Christians in a survey, when one said, I will invest the money and make a profit. Then I will build a building for church. This is the wise way. This is the wise thing to do. Invest the money. Then from the profit, you can build your pastor 200-seater church. Nobody will complain. This portrays understanding of what to do with money. Wise people know that they only spend the proceeds from one's capital, but never the capital. In the first law, we said, never eat capital.
Yes.
Come rain, come shine. Come burial, come naming ceremony. You have 20% savings. You see that capital? You see that capital? There's no need to go and borrow money and bury your father and become broke. Does it make sense? Does it make sense? That 20% that you're multiplying is your life. You have another 20% and you have your salary or your income. But that seed, no matter what happens, do not, that money is not your own. That money is not your own. And God will help you to make sure that nothing will make you to touch that money. See, remove it from your mind that that money is your own. Because if you kill the hen, how will you have hair the next morning? How? You now go and borrow money. For when you have something, and that is the seed, that is the seed that God gives you that you will use. So the summary from the founding is that most of Christians are not prepared. They are not ready to be entrusted, for God to entrust them with money. And so that's why God is not entrusting them with money, because they have no clue how money works. They have no clue. Any questions before I go to investment and groundwork? Can I have water? Any questions? Speak now, forever remain silent. Yeah.
Questions?
I just want to bring, I was not around the last two meetings, first and second of money. I've been blessed so far. But I was just wondering, when you asked the question, what was the first of money? I was just wondering, and I was surprised when you said it was multiplication of money. Yes. So I was wondering, before you multiply money, I was thinking something should come before
savings.
Multiplying money.
He says it's a multiplication.
So before you multiply money, it's the money that comes to you that you multiply. So how do you get the money to come to you first? I was wondering, I was thinking that should have been the first law. How to get the money to come into your hand before now talking about multiplying what has come to your hand. I was just wondering.
Okay. If you say what to do, because that is another teaching entirely.
Yes.
It's outside the scope of building wealth. If you have nothing to do, then you look for a job. You look for a job or you start a business. I'm dealing with income. I'm not dealing with starting up a business. There are two different things. So what you are saying is that a startup, where do I start from? Look for a job. Then the income from that job is how I'm teaching you how to multiply it. Then if you and you don't have a job, what can I begin to do around me to begin to earn small? Then even if you are earning 5,000 naira a month, you still start, there's a formula you will take. So that is not the law of money. The law of, you are talking about the law of startup. You are talking about startup. I'm talking about law of money. And you're already earning. And what you're earning, your salary, your take home is not taking you home. Your business is not, that is what we are dealing with here. Not in startups. Yes. Next year we'll talk about the ways to make money to earn. Yeah.
If I could recall you very briefly, you made mention of if there's no pressure, you can do anything. Now you made mention of bank giving people target to meet. Now, to some persons, does it apply to everybody? Because people like me, in particular, if you pressure me too much, that is not the best of me. That's why I always like my natural, like my own philosophy is that don't put me under pressure, I need to play it to work. For me, if I'm going to play anything, my aim was to play it to work. So I wouldn't know if it applies to everybody.
If you're not ready to be under pressure, you're not ready to have money.
Yes.
I'm sorry. You remain average for the rest of the night. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. That's the truth. I have clients that will call you to hear. Why are you not inside? And we move into that house. They be owing you 3 months. Then they just give you mobilization and they are causing you, abusing you, putting you under pressure. You can't have no pressure, you can't have no money. Life is pressure. Life is pressure. Even without adversity, you can't grow. You must go through God's university of adversity before you advance. Check all our patriarchs in the Bible. Which one is easy for? Check all of them. Without pressure, you can't grow. You need pressure. That is what will make you get up in the morning. And because, why do you go to work? Because you have a nasty boss. By the time he tells you one or two things, you by yourself want to respect yourself, you will believe it's 8 o'clock, you come there 8:30. It's pressure. If you do not have pressure, then there's no way you will do this in your own time, at your own time. Hell no. If you work for me, you can only last for 2 weeks. It's the truth. I give you a job, you want to do it at your own time, but no way now. You will do it at my own time, and my own time is not convenient for you because I can call you by 12 o'clock and we can begin to chat. It's not convenient for you. I know it's not convenient for you, but we have to end. Because that's how my own clients who are disturbing me. If I need to talk to people in China, I have to get up early. If I need to discuss with people in other countries, I have to get up. So why will you be sleeping? I'm discussing that you are sleeping, then you come to work and pay your salary. But all of us must get depression now. Because the money is coming from the same place. Yes, next question. For my brother, please. I'm just being too direct, but that is the only way I can answer you. I think you need to take time and deal with it. If you have time next year, let's talk. But there's just no other way. There's just no way. Yeah. Okay, let me move on to investment. Before you go into investment, you need to know how to do it and what to invest in. Many people go into bankruptcy. Why? Because they sow good seed into bad soil. And that's a way for you to lose all. And the reason why God does not give us wealth suddenly is because God uses systematic approach to entrust us with money that we see, and He expects us to grow it from time to time. And I've said, do not eat your business seed no matter what. The extent to which you can handle your seed determines the extent of the blessing God is going to give to you. You know, I also call pastors. I have some pastor friends that we talk that have their own churches. And I tell them, let me tell you, tithe and offering will never be enough. There's nothing that's ever enough. True wealth is investment. True wealth is an investment. It can never be enough. You must have streams of income. So even tithe and offering can be invested. It has to be invested. There has to be seed. We dealt with, in the first law, we dealt with extra income. And we dealt with non-essential income. These are monies that add up to the funds that you have that can be rolled over, invested, as long as the seed and the capital is not eaten. So the corporations, our corporations, even banks, they invest in themselves. True of us. Financial institutions, insurance will get money before they pay you their premium. They will invest that money so that if they have to pay a claim, they will pay your claim, but they have interest. It is a normal, basic thing. So nations, everybody needs to think about investment. Let me give you some tips about investment. 2 Timothy 2:15 says, study to show yourself approved unto God, a workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. If you do not study, you will lose money. So number one tip of investment is invest in companies and people and not in stock. If you want to invest in a stock, don't invest those things that you read out. No, don't invest based on adverts. Study the company and study the people behind that company. If the MD of that company has embezzled somewhere before, they are looking for him in America. There are chances that he can build that company like most Nigerian politicians can abandon that company and take that money and go and do election or support someone. You must study the temperament of the person, because it's human beings. If I want to deal with any organization, even before I will read your website, I will go to the management and I'll read about them and just look at them. Because if I'm going to interact with you, I need to know. Don't assume anything. Invest in companies and people. Number two, invest with people that are producing something, not MMM that have not producing nothing. Don't put your money in something that they're not producing. Don't say, I want to buy into this business that is not producing anything. Is it a product? And is the service worthwhile? And even if you want to invest in a company that is in services, look at them. Look at how they have innovated in the past 2 years. Are they people that are stuck in the way they are doing things? Or who are their partners? Some of this information, you can get it from their website. Before you deal with people, look at those basic things. What are they producing? A lot of people have lost their money in stock because they are not investing in. I've had a cousin that came down from the US dealing with a company that said it's producing something, and they asked him to buy 60% or 70%. No, they were asking him to buy 100%, that they want to sell off the company. And he said no, that they must retain something, that you okay, they finally agreed that you will buy 80% of the shares. Bros came down to Lagos. He saw the equipment they were producing, they were sweating. This was on a Friday. He said, okay, let him go to the village and he'll come back on Wednesday and they'll talk, because then they will have a meeting on Thursday before he will go back. By the time he came back on Wednesday, that place was a church. It was a laborer that was using it. The man was going crazy. It was a church. They were doing midweek service, white garments. They were doing midweek service. He said, no, I was here. They said, we don't understand what you are saying. They said, I was here, I gave them money. Can't you see paper for where the people have gone? You see, trust in faces, invest in faces. Invest in faces. Understand what is happening. Study the people. Then I think number four, right? Take calculated risk, do not gamble. What I'm trying to say, take calculated risk. In everything you must take risk. But let it be calculated. Don't be reckless in your decisions. Don't be reckless. And if you're doing this for the first time, number six, seek financial counseling before investing. You might need to befriend. I didn't have money to get a financial consultant now. I didn't have money. And they know that I didn't have money when I started work. So what I need to do is, I'll just, when you go to bank, and you sit down there, you just, then my MD was one of the largest shareholders in GT Bank. So when I go, it was like family. So we sit down and we will talk. We will talk. I'll be asking questions. They will be giving you lowdown of the current things. When you go to see your bank manager, why are you in a hurry? Sit down. He will tell you some things that are happening in the banking sector as a friend. So I didn't need to get a financial. I know how I would get ones that, if you have friends that are bankers, always make bankers your friends. Bankers and policemen, as I think of them. Try as much as possible if you have to go out late in the night, give them money. Policemen, they remember faces. Well. Just give them money. One day your truck will be in Bayelsa and you will go there, you see somebody you gave money 10 years ago in Benin. So that I mean that now you okay, bro. You need the police, whether you like it or not. You're an entrepreneur. Try and not dine with them, more, but try and know them, because dining with them is a different matter. I can't say it on this thing, it's a different matter. But you need them for the advancement of your business. Okay? So, whoever you need, government officials, know the ones that are your mates now. Always. My uncle gave me this advice and I stuck to it. Can you imagine? My mates now are ambassadors. Because I wanted, my father didn't want me to work in government. He said I don't have a temperament, that he doesn't want to hear the sacky song. So everything he said, you will not go to government. And all I wanted to do was enter into foreign service or go to the bank. Those were the two things I had in mind. My mates are now ambassadors. They are approaching level 16. Some of them that have level 17. Do you understand? Those are the people that sign papers. Those are the directors, assistant directors. I have juniors that are assistant directors. I have juniors that are PAMSEC. Some are luckier than the others if you know how to play. So what am I saying? If you don't know them, is it that time you want to come? You must be in touch with government people. There's nothing you can do in life that you cannot do with them, as annoying as they can be. But you need them. And they will give you one or two tips. You need them. Okay, the last one is, do not put all your eggs in one basket as an investor. So you have to spread yourself. Ecclesiastic 11, 1 and 12 say, cast your bread on many waters, but calculated risk with wisdom. Okay, I want us to talk about investment sense. Investment sense. There's something that is called investment sense. You know, I'm giving you what the world says. The difference between what the world says and marketplace is that we have the God factor. So we have the carrier of God's wisdom in the person of the Holy Spirit. So we should have, there's a sense to everything. There's a way to go about it. And like I said, wealth is a culture, is a mindset. So you are training yourself to understand, you know that thing they call village sense? Is what I'm calling investment sense. And I'm not even talking about, not everybody will go through these tips. There are people that are investing. I want you to learn it. Proverbs 3:3-5. Put your trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. Acknowledge him in all your ways, and he will do what? Direct your paths. These were the prayers I was praying. Proverbs 16:3. It says, commit your works unto the Lord. He will establish your thoughts. So I now started praying for wisdom for investment. Wisdom. I've gone through a lot of classes in wisdom and in investment. I know a lot of courses, I've read a lot. But I still, some things did not add up. Because I say, is it only through this stock market, through this financial, through all these things that I'll be able to invest? How about the day-to-day things that pass us by? And it is in this quest to understand that I started understanding God is teaching a concept. So when you understand the concept of multiplying money, the God factor here is giving you opportunity to invest. Because God knows that you can now handle money. But I'm talking about investment for 1,000 naira. They used to call me the fixer. I can fix anything for you, Brother Davey. It's not, see, it doesn't have to be something big. It doesn't have to be something big. There are very few people that you want something, whatever you can do, whatever service you can render to someone, there should be a price tag to it. I know the first thing you need to kill is that you kill that thing, friend, that thing, family.
Yes, sir.
Kill it from your mindset.
Yes,
sir. The only thing you are doing for friend and family is you are giving them small discount. Do you want to hear the interpreter of things? He's thinking profit, not thinking family. He can come back and help family, but he needs to make it. What I'm saying is develop on a daily basis. I pray. There's no day I will leave my study. I will not pray. God, give me an investment opportunity. And anywhere I go, I am listening to people. And I sit down here. Sometimes it's now like an addiction to me. The Bible calls it exercising your faith. Whatever is predominant in your mind, you attract. So, you see that, you see the world from who you are on the inside. Because a friend of mine was always, he calls churches, business center, blah, 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 is part of the people that say all that nonsense. I said, you see the aspect of money changing hand in church, because that is what you want to see. You are not seeing, you are blinded by what is in your mind. So now, if you decide to start thinking investment, that is all you see. It's just a train yourself. Everything is habit. It takes 21 days to form a habit. It takes 21 days. Thanks, I'll be moving now. Tell my wife, I see this guy. He say, Uche, 1,000 naira. Igbo man, I say, leave her like that. See, let me tell you, it is not in the 1,000 naira. It's not in what they call you. It's a culture that I have developed over time. People come to me for counseling. I hold myself. Because the one you came for, I'm laughing. I said, you know they see this one. And I won't say anything because I don't get into people's business. So I'll advise you on what you came for. And I'm not special. I have just trained myself to think investment, to think increase, and to think gain. That's all. What you surround yourself with is what you're going to become. I surround myself with the Word of God. I surround myself with the Bible, and I surround myself with principles. When I started this, when Marketplace Apostle started, it was, when will I get principle to be teaching on a daily basis? It was an issue for me. And the Lord said, no, am I not the one that sent you? Whatever you focus becomes your reality. See, if you want to buy, which car do you like all now? Maybe you want to buy Honda, which one? Give me a Honda. Honda Accord. A particular model. To you, you think that model is not everywhere. It's a bit scarce. Because all of us want to have what many people don't have, right?
Yes.
But the day you decide in your mind, there's something they call it, you can't remember now, that you want to buy that car. Do you know you start seeing that car everywhere?
Yes.
Huh?
Yes.
It's the same thing I'm telling you. The same way when you start thinking gain and investment, all you hear is money. All you hear is opportunity here. All you hear is that I can put, and all I'm telling you, start to make 1,000, 5,000. Start to make small money. God wants to see that once you train yourself to see that, God is going to send you a 1 million naira contract that you make gain of 500,000. And you use 500,000 to do. But you already have 680,000, so it's not a problem. So you can take 500,000 from that seed, do that business and return it, you have profit. That's how it works. God rewards faithfulness. My Niger Delta brothers, God rewards faithfulness. God does not reward, let's go, hey, yeah, let's break, let's kill. Let them give us 1 billion and we don't know the loss of money. And we eat that money and that money finishes. What do you do with the collection? Collection, God has blessed you from where you come. What do you do with it? What do you do with it? You should be the one that is coming up with ideas in your community. We can do this for do this. Generate that interest. Bring up those ideas. There are daily things that happen. And you also can begin to see that. And let me tell you, in business, as I need to leave now, in business, think asset, not liability. I talked about land one time. I know I talked about house. And we discussed it a bit, and I said, let's not discuss it until we get to investment. Building a house, is it an asset or a liability? Okay, fine. If it's for commercial, it's fine. It's asset. But how long will it take you to get your return on investment? Answer me now, Professor. Bro, answer me. Two of you answer me. But my blood is hot. I need that.
You sell.
So Aman, if you want to, you know, all of us say, you know, when money enters your house, I want to buy land. I want to build a house. It's for status. It's not for. Those are the things that should come after you build wealth. After you've created wealth, people build, see, 20 rooms, apartments. They don't live in it. You have 30 rooms, mansion. You have only 2 children. What sense is in that? The children are abroad, they are never going to come back. So why do we do what we do? Critically analyze it. I know you will have a place to rest your head at some point. But in creating wealth, that building might not be priority. Land is an asset because he appreciates. But building a house for yourself, just for yourself, not for any command, it's liability. Because you are paying to maintain it. So why not? You see some people, they will build maybe 3 or 4 semi-detached bungalows. So they will live in one. And there are other 2 or 3. This is the mindset. You are the landlord there. Those 3 are the ones paying for your rent. Because you also will pay rent for your house. And the maintainers in your house, those people. If you're able to faithfully do that, you will have money to build another set and another set of estate, as they call it, until you get to a point you cannot build yourself. And you're supposed to go around that circle 10 times. before you can build one for yourself, anything that you like. At that point, it doesn't matter. You know the concept. The money is already there. It doesn't matter. Your kids are growing up to understand this. At that time, it's okay. Why do you want to put money into something that is not bringing money to you now? See, if you understand this asset and liability, asset and liability. How much will you pay in transport and having a car? You need to do that calculation. The car takes you to work. The car takes you, yes, it will take you to church, it will take you to all those things. But how much do you think that that car is contributing to your work? That will determine whether you need a car. Is someone getting what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Because the car, you need to justify it to yourself. Ah, sir, the car will take, because I asked a young man, he had to justify it. Say, sir, I live very far. This car saves me time and ability for me to retain my job and to meet my clients in the night, because he does leather works in the night. So it means that that car helps him to get to, helps him to move around faster and also contributing to his night business, which is his building to become his mainstay. And when he goes to buy materials, he loads it in the car. So in that sense, in that way, it's justified. But if you can't really justify that, we're saying 2 years, tighten your belt for 2 years. Tighten your belt for 2 years. And save. Justify every money going out. Justify. Some things need to go. Some things need to go for now. Certain things need to go. Certain things need to go. They need to go. You see, money, multiplying it, you know, putting 1,000, 2,000. I talked about, for some of you who are not here, non-essential expenses. Do you know I calculated my non-essential, the first time I calculated my non-essential expenses, 500,000, I screamed for 7 months. I said, God forbid that thing. What is this non-essential? Go. Non-essential are things that you can do without. Instead of taking that job, let me just enter transport. It's not because you cannot afford the job. Don't mind what people will say. Enter transport or you check it. You can even keep fit. We don't exercise. Use that. What are those things? DSTV. Sometimes at home and in Bona. It's just, you just bone it for, bone that thing for 4 months. Sometimes you just overlook. Sometimes make call. Instead of going out, make call. See, those, that amount that you save. So what you begin to do now is that you are having allotted, you are allotting a particular amount to phone call, to data. Not in the morning, you just put on data now and be browsing. There must be time. So you know that you are browsing, and this is the amount you are allocating to data for the month. And let me tell you, once that amount passes, you leave it like that till the next month. You won't die. Because you are in the process, or you are building something. You are building something. And when that money comes, don't be moved to go to your village and build 20 rooms, and so that you can tell that uncle that said nobody in your father's house is going to rise. In the village, you're not retiring to. How many of us are going to retire to feel the ditch? No, in this room now. How many of us are going to retire to feel the ditch? So what are we building those things then? What are we building? The only thing I want to build in my village, I was hearing rumor that they say they want to move NYSC camp there. I say we'll relocate now so that we'll go and become landlord and build one bedroom for coppers and NYSC. That is the essence for you to build those things. What do you need more than 2 rooms to place to stay 2 days, 1 day, 3 days? I don't have father there now. What am I doing again now? There's nothing to go and do with what? It's not there. My mother has not finished doing of Mugo. She's online for Mugo, from one to the other. So what am I doing there? Do you understand? There's no economic, there's nothing there. Which sentiment? Which sentiment? I'm looking for an agreed this thing. To bring any company that say that part of Delta State is lucrative for farming. Come, I have plenty land, I'll give you. I have plenty farm. That's what I'm looking for. Not to go and build house there for what? Okay, now, let's talk about buildings that you can invest in. Talk about, do you know now that, favor, do you know that I went somewhere? People quote for event hall. People quote for guest houses to companies. People tell them the benefits. Not that you build, you will go and call them. People go to banks and go to people that will use that thing that they want to build. So those things are assets from the one. They are building from the mindset that this thing will produce. They are not building, oh, let me build and I'll go to Shell and be disturbing them able to come. Then look at the trends. Port Harcourt does not have event centers enough in the area where people want it. Because if you go and build 10,000 seater event center all somewhere, nobody will come. You can imagine if you have 100 seater somewhere in Stadium Road. Do you think you will rest? You will not rest now. Those are the kind of things that you will invest in. You can say, okay, let me try. Because I see that I have done feasibility in Port Harcourt. This is needful. Let me try. But even at in trying that, don't go it alone. Reduce the risk. Bring in partners. Bring in the bank. You know that rich people never use their money. For never. For what? The rich man carries money and do project. For what? It's bank loan now. And you will give him that loan based on his name. You are not writing anything for him. There are some people that will enter your bank and you tell you say collateral for what? They are collateral. They are themselves. They are all the collateral you need. You can, you see, what companies need now is creative thinking, which I've taught here, disruptive thinking. What is it that companies want? Offer them. And don't do anything without having a market for it. Or even if there is no market for it, but you see that the need is there, then you can step up and begin to invest. Be bold. When I started this series, I said something. God said, your dream is too small. Can somebody remember? Your dream is too small. Your dream is too small. Those of you in the IT, your dream is too small. Your dream is too small. I wish I was in IT. I wish IT was now what it was during my time. I am telling you. Because I deal with it every day. There are companies that are ready to come and buy. And then, do you know how much they bought it? Do you know how much they bought it? The guy used it to go and start Flutterwaves. Now he's moving on to other things. In the IT world, they are doing crazy stuff. And I'm presenting myself because I am an influencer. You have the wisdom, but I'm an influencer. So we will come together and let's do something.
Yes, yes.
It's true. Because the wealth is in the hand of these IT people and these young people. Don't struggle with them in that IT and social media. Don't struggle. Just partner with them. Come alongside. At my age, I want to follow Daniel and be tweeting. I can't try it now. What will I be doing then? But I'm an influencer. He needs me now. Become a principality. All his knowledge, you can't pass through. There are people that own some doors.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So we will negotiate at the door. Even Jesus said, settle quick on the way. Uh-huh. Now you will settle me quick on the way. With some shares in that your company. It's the truth. A lot is happening in the IT world. A lot is happening. How about mercy? People need to release me and talk too much. How about medicine? You don't need to be a doctor now. They are moving from, what do they call it? Curative to preventive. So now I don't need to be a doctor to start a health. You can start a health program. You see these Chinese, Malaysian people, they will bring out and not even put they'll not even put what do they call this multi-level marketing?
Supplements.
Yes. What's the common one we use to call it? Network, I hate that thing. Anything that does not build businesses, I'm not there. Anything that does not build businesses, I'm not there. Because nothing is sustaining it. It's like building your house on the sand. When that flood comes, it is going. It's going. Nothing will stop it. Nothing's like gambling. There's no matter how you gamble, you gamble. They are watching you now. Go to Vegas now. Go to Las Vegas. They are watching you. They just give you crumbs. You win to keep you addicted. After the first, they see that this guy is a fresh face. Within 1 month, you will win. Then for the next 10 years, you will not win anything. But that urge is like, okay, coming there to buy. People are manipulating who will win and who will not win now.
Yeah.
Will you come to my house and know the biggest meat in this depot? It's not possible. So how do you think that you go to his God with some people who go pray and fast, they will go and bet? Bet what man controls? No, think of now. Bet to what somebody controls. Check it now. What somebody controls. The opportunities are huge. I'm talking about purity with medicine. There's so many in food, lifestyle. Now they're pushing lifestyle. Instead of taking drugs, lifestyle. Managing old people are giving me ideas. Managing my parent, my mom, is giving me wild ideas. Do you know that you can employ doctors and send them? And people don't like to go to hospital. Two things I don't like, banking and hospital. Because they waste your time.
Yes.
You go fill form, you come here, you collect card, you do things, then you wait. I hate those two things. But somebody can bring that hospital to you. Somebody can bring that to you. I go to where they massage. Now there's an option, they carry that massage and bring it for me anywhere I am. They told me that even if I'm in VIP lounge in the airport, they will come there to give me that treatment. But we see the same price as going there. That's what I'm saying. This opportunity, this one I'm telling you, that we have not talked about putting money in, we dealt that one in multiplication, so I'm not going there. Just be thinking like this because this is how I think. I've said it here many times. The one I'm thinking is, how do I get footballers to wear a vest that is cold so the heat is when drop it? Because those vests footballers wear, there's heat sensors inside that keep them warm. How can in winter cold is what they are playing football? Don't you think something is sustaining them there? The average Nigerian saying that juju, don't mind that when you go juju, then they use it. It's a sense. Those are the kind of things that will turn you to a billionaire in one day. That is the princes that are coming. That's what is going to transform Africa. So whether Nigerian government agree or not, agree with yourself. And we will agree with you here to help you to become all. These are the laws. They are more than this, but these are the basics. We'll continue with the law of money. We'll continue with money, even for the first quarter. How? What are the sources of money? That is one of the topics I'm dealing with. How does money come? Well, many people are confused. There are five basic ways money comes. To be able to make it, you need to understand it. And some of this is what I'm teaching. Disruptive thinking. Google it and read it. Disruptive thinking also changing your nature. No, I need to see things differently. If you start looking for money in everything, if you start not looking for opportunities in everything, you will begin to think differently because not everybody is thinking that way. Everybody is thinking that these clients that I have, how do I milk them? But you are thinking that I need to bring out a different service. I need to bring out a different product. My business can come from the same. Can I do it in this way? And when I say, let me tell you, the fastest way to get business ideas is what people are saying.
Yes.
Where I'm coming from now, I wrote down five businesses. And guess what? Sometimes I throw away the paper. Sometimes I'm not doing it because I know I can't do it. But I have already trained myself so I listen. Then a friend of mine said, why don't you write these ideas and begin to sell them? Because those ideas are like songs. He said, like I'm a songwriter that does not have voice to sing. That's why he describes me. I'm a songwriter that doesn't have voice to sing. I have the idea, but I don't have time. Because apart from doing what I do, I'm also a spiritual leader. And you can't go to the Holy Spirit and you dictate to him, I will use you. No. So, but you can use those ideas and you can be transformed. Thank you. See you next year. Thank you for coming. Please enjoy the feast and the prayers that will be led. Please don't be in a hurry to leave. Just let's bond.